Hello, my name is Chris Schalk. I'm a Google Developer Advocate, and I'm here with Yoichiro Tanaka, the creator of OSDE, which is an Eclipse plugin that allows you to do open social development entirely within Eclipse. So let's go ahead and do a demonstration of how to use the OSDE plugin inside of Eclipse. So first of all, after I've installed the Eclipse plugin, I can create a new project, and you'll notice the project type here is an open social project now. And so I'll click Next, and I'll just give it a basic name, like OSDE Test. And I'll give it a title, like say the same thing, OSDE Test, as well as I'll just fill in the author email. You'll also notice that I can specify other features, such as the OpenSocial version, as well as other just general gadget features. But I'll just accept the default and click on Next. And now on this page, I can create different views for Canvas, Profile, Preview, Home, etc. So in this case, I'm going to create two views, one for Canvas of type HTML, and I'm going to go ahead and create external JavaScript in a separate file, as well as generate a little bit of JavaScript file in the form of an init function. And I'll do the same thing for the profile view, so of type HTML, generate some JavaScript. And then at this point, I'll click Finish. And this will create our new OpenSocial Developer Environment project. So I can open this up, and so you can see I have our gadget.xml. So that's our gadget spec, as well as two JavaScript files that contain the code for each view. Now you notice the gadget.xml file is already open, and we're looking at a editor. It's like a simplified editor, so I can just enter in the fields directly here. Likewise, I can open up and specify the different options. And now if I also, on the bottom, I can tab through. So for example, if I wanted to access the different views directly through here, I can edit the views inside here. Likewise, I can change the locale or add internationalization for my gadget application. Same thing for user preference. And then finally, if I want to just edit the source code directly for my gadget, I can just click on source and edit this way. So in this case, the code that's defined here as a default is actually pretty easy. It's just a simple div. I'm going to actually replace the code with some of my own code. And I happen to have some code handy here. So first of all, I'll just create like my own div where I'm going to display my friends instead of what's generated here. And then likewise, I'm going to go into the canvas.js file. I'm going to open that into a text editor. And right now it's just an empty init file, init function that is. And so let me switch back over to my ready-to-go JavaScript code. And all I'm doing is I'm loading in two functions, load friends and then unload friends, and then I'm actually replacing the init function here. And what this code does is it simply goes and fetches a set of friends and displays it into the gadget body itself. Okay, so let me just paste that in there. And now I'll hit save. So now I'm ready to run the application, but before I run it, I'll actually have to start up the local Apache server. And so in this case, as you notice here on the menu bar, there's a little icon there that looks like the OpenSocial icon, and it says Launch Apache Shindig Server. So let's go ahead and click on that, and that will launch essentially Apache Shindig right here, and you can see the progress of it in the console. And then once the server is ready to go, I'll be able to launch my application. And I do that by clicking on the gadget, and I can do a right click, and then as you notice here, I have an OSDE, and then run application. What this actually does is fires up a separate Jetty server process that allows the gadget to be accessed from the Shindig server. Okay, so I click run this application, and likewise I can change various default or various settings, so like what's the owner, what's the viewer, as well as the country and language, or if I wanted to see it in an external web browser. So for this one, because I already have sample data in the database, and that's a feature as well that's provided, I'll just select the viewer as John Doe and click OK. And so now I'm running the application entirely locally. And it's fetching the gadget, and there we go. I can see the actual friends of John.Doe working directly within the gadget. So now I have created my gadget. I can go ahead and test it further. But at this point, I can say, okay, great. I want to go ahead and create, say, a Java an OpenSocial Java client application. And so we have this feature here in OSDE that allows you to create a Java project for the RESTful protocol that will create a sample bit of code. So I'll just create this REST project. And at that point, I can just accept the defaults and hit finish. And that will create a new project. And I can click yes. That will allow us to jump into the Java perspective. So here we are. We actually have a new sample Java client code that will go against our local server, which is still running, by the way. And I can go through and specify, instead of like C#, I can say, let's go ahead and keep it john.doe, which is part of the sample data. And at this point, I can run the application since it has a main method in here. So let's go ahead, click Run as Java Application, and then we'll watch the console. And as you notice here in the console, it actually went out and fetched the same friends directly from the server, but this time it was using the REST protocol. And that pretty much concludes the demonstration. The only other thing I wanted to show is that you have like a nice menu option here. You can also create the sample data. So this is actually a first step that you'd want to do. I can show you the public certificate for OAuth. And I would say that concludes the demonstration of OSDE, a Eclipse plugin that allows you to do open social development entirely inside of Eclipse. Thank you.